Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. To know more about this video, Standard Deviation Graph in Excel, watch the video till the end, and also if you're new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon that's given below. Welcome everyone, and today's topic is Standard Deviation Graph in Excel. Now, in this particular topic, we are going to learn some of the nitty-gritties in terms of how this Excel chart is prepared. So basically, the meaning. We will try and run through how to create a standard deviation graph in Excel, a very vital and the most imperative thing to learn because we are trying to touch base that topic. And what are the things that you should remember about the standard deviation graph in Excel? So let's begin. See, remember that as we know that standard deviation is absolutely calculated, you know, it is basically a calculation of how the values are changing with comparison or respect of the mean or the average values. Okay, so you need to understand that how those values are changing, and there are two deviations. It is represented in the graph of standard deviation. One which are positive to the mean, which is shown on the right hand side of the graph, and another are negative in the process, which is to the mean, which are shown on the left hand side of the graph. So the standard deviation graph is also known as a bell-shaped curve graph in Excel. Well, standard deviation is one of the most important statistical tool which shows, you know, how the data is basically, you can say, spread out. Like for example, in the stock market, how the stock prices is so volatile in nature. Right, so typically the standard deviation is basically the variation of either side of the average or means values or the data series. So we can plot the standard deviation in the Excel graph, and the graph is called as the bell-shaped curve. Now the bell curve in the graph, which is commonly used to, you can say, the gauge the performance appraisal of the employees in the company. So all the organization work on the performance appraisal for a specific period of time. Using the performance appraisal, they reward employees in terms of salary, promotion, and so on and so forth. So, they gouge the employees on low, or probably completely non-performers, if there are any. Or probably you can say any of the average performers, okay, or high performers, and so on and so forth. So, when you plot a bell-shaped graph, it shows the highest probability of the outcome, and the probability of the outcome keeps going down. And when the bell shapes move to the either side from the center point. For example, let me show you a graph. Assume that you are working in a team of 15 members and your rating is very similar to the other team members. Then only few employees would have got a higher rating. So a majority will get an average rating and few of them will get a very lower rating. So if you got 8 as a rating and your team has got 7 as the rating, there won't be much of the difference, isn't it? So to make the comparison felt like a bell-shaped curve or best fit to the gauge to the employees and the rate, then reward them accordingly. Now all the higher rating employees in the bell curve will be placed on the right hand side of the curve, and the lower rating of the employee will be felt on the or will be placed on the left hand side of the bell curve, and the average employee will be placed in the center of the bell curve. Well, in order to understand the Excel standard deviation graph or bell shaped curve, we need two kind of calculations here. One that is mean, okay, or you can say the average of the data series, and the second is one is the standard deviation, which is shown how to spread the data series. For example, if the average score of the student class is 70 and the SD, that is standard deviation, is 5, then the students scored with either side of the mean, that is 70, first range will be 65 to 70, and second range will be 70 to 75. Now, how to create this kind of standard deviation graph in Excel? So, for a better understanding of the standard deviation graph in Excel, let's consider how real life example of the student marks in an examination. Let me take some of the numbers first before I jump on things. Well, I'll just write from 0.5 and I'll keep adding 0.5 from here till 16. Okay. So the first thing we need to do is to calculate the average score of the examination. Now, you will apply the average. Okay. So I'll just use the formula is equal to average. Select the entire and 4.25. Okay. 4.25 is closely coming down to average. If you want, you can increase down to closely some of the more numbers. Okay, now the data has been properly been recorded. So secondly, you need to calculate over here is called as the standard deviation. So this is your average. Now the standard deviation so is equal to STDEV. So you take the second one. Estimates the standard deviation based on a sample and ignores the logical values and text in a sample. So over here, you will take the entire data. So now you have 4.11 close to as your standard deviation. Now, since you need to note here that, you know, I have not taken sample data, I have used the STDVES, which is used as a sample data series. Now, there is another formula that's for the normal distribution. Okay, that is for the normal distribution. Now, in that particular scenario, how things will work? So, the formula is equal to normal distribution. So, that is x. Okay, here x is nothing but our past data points. So, select here 0.5, that is your first value, okay, and mean, the next thing that is our average, right, which we have already calculated, okay, mean is your average, so comma, your average, okay, next is the, what they are asking is standard deviation, okay. So, okay, we are writing standard deviation. And remember one, fix this completely, fix this comma. You are asking true or false. So, next thing is cumulative. So, select false probability as mass function. Okay. Now, false is the argument and close the bracket. 0.26 somewhere close the line, that's the normal distribution. So drag the formula if you want, or what I'll do is probably just take the formula here. Okay, it is showing me ref error. So what I'll do, I'll just apply it here itself, is equal to normal distribution x mean, then my standard deviation, false, close the bracket, and just press Control D till the end. So now you have got, okay, I forgot to fix this, and that's why it is showing me num error. Okay, so now create a standard deviation Excel graph using the steps that I'm going to show you. Step number one, you need to select the data, okay, and then you need to go to insert. So you need to select this entire data. Now once you select this data, and you need to go to the insert tab. Now inside the insert tab, you know, under the charts section, if you see, there are various sort of charts, as you can see. So in this, residence scattered with smooth lines. Okay, so select this chart. Now you will have a chart something like this. Okay, so if needed, you can change the chart axis and title and so on and so forth. Okay, I find this is more interesting one. So conclusion out of this, our standard deviation is 3.82, which is slightly higher. So our bell curve is wider. And if the standard deviation is small, then we will get a very slim bell curve. Now, I hope you have understood how the chart has been made. But apart from this, I want you to understand how or what things you should make sure or you need to remember about standard deviation. See, the mean or the average values are always the center point of the Excel standard deviation graph, approximately closely around 68.2% of the data series, which will be fitted in the range of the mean of 65 to 70. Okay, and approximately you can say 95.5% will fit. Will range into 2 into mean minus standard deviation plus again 2 into mean plus standard deviation. And the 99.7% approximately of the data set is will be fitted into 3. So here it will be 2 into mean minus standard deviation. Here it will be 3 into mean. So the Excel standard deviation graph shape depends on the standard deviation value. So higher, remember this relation, higher the SD standard deviation value, wide the bell curve and smaller is the SD value. Slimmer is the bell curve is. Now, complete knowledge of the bell curve can be best explained with the help by a statistical person. And I hope after learning this, you have got a great idea regarding this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like, comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for all the latest updates. Thank you everyone once again for joining this session.